Let us do a question on the topic that we discussed in the previous video, earthing of paddle plate system. The two paddle plate system we have already understood. Let us say in this we have three plates. We have three paddle plates A, B and C. A, B and C, in which only B has a charge Q. Let the distance between these two D and the distance here, let us say, is 2D. Only B has charge Q and A and C are connected to Earth. Now, if we had only this plate, if only B were there, then this charge will be equally divided in the form of plus Q by 2 and plus Q by 2 on both surfaces. But since that is not happening, because of the unequal distances, the distance here is D and the distance here is 2D. So that means this Q will be divided unequally on the both surfaces. So let us say this surface has charge Q1 and this surface has charge Q2. Obviously, both of the charges will be positive. Now, the electric field because of this charge will be in this direction and the electric field because of this charge will be in this direction. Now, because of plus Q1, a minus Q1 charge will be distributed here and this will get plus Q1 charge. Because of this plus Q2, a minus Q2 charge will deposit here and this will deposit plus Q2 charge here. Now, in this condition, if the switches are closed and A and C are connected to Earth, then we know that E1, let us say this is E1 and let us say this is E2, what will happen here, that E1 will be equal to Q1 upon A epsilon naught and E2 will be equal to Q2 upon A epsilon naught. This charge plus Q1 and this plus Q2 will go towards the Earth and the final charge on the outer surfaces will be equal to zero, as we have studied in the previous video. Now, in this condition, in this existing condition, we know that the plates that are connected to Earth should be at zero potential. That means A should be at zero potential and C should be at zero potential. In other words, we can say that the potential difference between B and A should be equal to the potential difference between B and C. Let us say they both are zero, and if it was at V, then the potential difference between V, between A and B is V minus 0, and between B and C is also equal to V minus 0. So the potential difference between these two plates should be equal to the potential difference between these two plates, B and C. So we can write VAB equals to VBC. Putting the formula, this can be written as VAB can be written as E1D. Because the electric field here is E1 and the distance between them is D, so VAB is equal to E1D and similarly VBC equals to E2 into 2D. Putting the values of E1 and E2, we can write this as Q1D upon A epsilon naught equals to Q2 2D upon A epsilon naught. Now, if we solve this, we'll get an equation that Q1 equals to 2Q2. Let us say that this is our first equation. Now, we also know that Q1 and Q2 are the charges that were originated here. So, the summation of Q1 and Q2 should be equal to capital Q from our initial situation. Let us say this is our second equation. Now, if we solve first and second equation, we can find the values of Q1 and Q2. I'll write it here. If we solve these two equations, Q1 will come out to be 2Q by 3 and Q2 will come out to be Q by 3. So that means we can say that on closing the switches to Earth, the charge of plus 2Q by 3, because this was plus Q1, so plus Q1 is plus 2Q by 3. And Q2, this was plus Q2, so this was Q by 3. So we can say the charges of 2Q by 3 and Q by 3 flowed in the Earth when the Earth switch was closed. So So this will be the final situation, and these will be the values of Q1 and Q2.